Very good morning to one and all. Myself Swati. I'm an assistant professor in the department of ECO of St. Martin's Engineering College. Today I'm going to discuss about the rectifiers. Okay. First of all, what is rectifier? Rectifier is a device which converts alternating current into pulsating DC, unidirectional DC. Okay.
What is rectifier? We will discuss now.
Rectifier is a device which converts alternating current, AC current, into unidirectional DC. That is unidirectional DC. It converts alternating current into unidirectional DC. One of the major application of the diode is rectifier. Okay.
So coming to the classification of the rectifiers are three types. First one is the off-wave rectifier. Full-wave rectifier. Two-wave rectifier. And the bridge rectifier.
Okay, rectifier is a device which converts alternating current into unidirectional DC, but it not converted into pure DC. It converts pulsating DC. We are having three types of rectifiers: off-wave rectifier, full-wave rectifier, and the bridge rectifier. First, we will discuss about the off-wave rectifier. Of the rectifier. Okay, off-wave rectifier is defined as like, is the type of rectifier, it allows the only off cycle and it will block the remaining off cycle. Okay, first coming to the rectifier, it converts the alternating current. Okay, this is the alternating current, it will be rectified here. Okay, this is the rectifier, it will convert it into the unidirectional DC. Okay, this current will be converted into the unidirectional DC. Okay, this is the rectifier. Coming to the off-wave rectifier, the name itself only indicates it will be allows the only half cycle of the part will be, it will be in the allows, remaining half cycle will be blocks. Okay, how it will block the remaining half cycle? By using the transformer. Okay, so now we will discuss. We are applying some AC voltage here. What is the AC voltage we are using here? 230 volts AC and 50 hertz frequency. Okay, we are giving the alternating current to the transformer. This is the primary winding. This is the secondary winding. Okay, for finding the half-wave rectifier, we are giving rectification purpose here using the diode here. This is the PN junction diode. For output purpose, we are using the load resistor here, that will be indicated by the RL. Okay, what will happen in the half-wave rectifier? Now we will see. This is the applied input signal. We are applying alternating current. This is the, we are applying alternating current, 230 volts, 50 hertz frequency. This is the AC sub power supply we are giving to the transformer winding. This is point A, this is B, and this is the diode D1. This is the load resistor R1. This is the transformer winding N1, and this is the N2 gear. Okay. When we are applying AC voltage to this transformer, what will happen in the forward bias condition? Okay, in the positive half cycle, these are the positive half cycle. When we are applying AC voltage to the primary winding, this is the positive half cycle. In the first half cycle, what will happen? In the first half cycle, what is the condition? Okay, what will happen in the first half cycle? When we are applying, so first, when we are applying 230 volts AC power supply to the first positive half cycle, what will happen? Okay, then the diode will be in the forward bias condition. Then how the current will flow? The current will flow from the direction A, diode D1 and the load resistor RL and the point B. Okay, this is the direction of the current flow when the first positive half cycle. Okay, so the diode will be in the forward bias condition. What will happen? The first positive cycle will be occurred here as this. Okay, next we have to take the second half cycle. Okay, second half cycle. Okay, when we are applying negative half cycle. Okay, when we are applying negative half cycle means, so the current flow will be in the reverse direction. The current flow will be in the reverse direction like this. Okay, how the current will be flow in the second half cycle? Second negative half cycle. Okay, what will happen in the second negative half cycle? The direction of the current flow in the reverse bias. So, the direction of the current flow will be go from B, load resistor RL, B, RL, diode D1 and the point K. What will happen? So, what is the condition of the diode? Diode, it allows the current in only single direction, that will be in the forward direction only. So, in the negative cycle, what will happen? The flow of the current will be in the reverse bias. So, reverse bias condition, the diode will not allow the flow of the current here. So, there is no flow of the current here. So, there is no flow of current here. So, it will be approximately equals to zero. So, the process will be repeated as it is. Okay, so only what will happen in the power wave rectifier, only positive half cycle of the current will be allowed. Remaining half cycle it will be blocks. Okay, this is the condition for the power wave rectifier. So coming to the advantages, so remaining what will happen, it allows in the positive half cycle, it blocks the negative half cycle. Okay, this is the input of the half wave rectifier, this is the output of the half wave rectifier. Okay, it allows only half cycle, remaining half cycle will be blocks here and same as this process will be continuous here. Okay, this is the half wave rectifier. Okay, the coming to the construction, it is very easy construction and it is very low cost. These are the advantages. It is very low construction and easy to construct, and compared to the other rectifiers, it is low cost. This is the advantage. But coming to the disadvantages, the half of the cycle will be blocked here. So that's where we'll go to the full wave rectifier. Okay, coming to the characteristics of the half wave rectifier, what are the characteristics we are having in the half wave rectifier is the coming to the characteristics of the half wave rectifier, first we will have in the efficiency. So efficiency will be denoted by the letter eta. Okay, efficiency is the ratio of output power to the ratio of output power to the input power. Ratio of output power to the input power. Okay, the efficiency of the this half-wave rectifier is 81.2%. This is the one characteristic. Coming to the ripple factor. Efficiency of the half-wave rectifier is 81.2, and coming to the ripple factor is defined as the how much amount of AC content will be present in the output of the DC. Okay, ripple factor is the AC content will be present in the DC. Okay, that is called a ripple factor. Ripple factor of this half wave rectifier is 0.48. Okay, next to peak inverse voltage. Coming to the third characteristics, peak inverse voltage. The name itself only indicates peak inverse voltage. Peak inverse voltage is the, this is the reverse voltage that can appears in the diode in the reverse bias condition. When we are connecting the diode, diode in the reverse bias condition, what is the maximum voltage? What is the maximum voltage appears in the diode? That is diode, that inverse, that voltage is called as the peak inverse voltage. That peak inverse voltage is 2 Vm. Why 2 Vm is the, in the reverse bias condition, what is the voltage here? So it will block. So what is the maximum voltage? Suppose we are applying 2 volts, mean the 2 volts voltage will be appear across the same. So how much voltage appear? That is 2 Vm. Vm is the, this one, maximum voltage. This will be denoted by the letter Vm. So what is the negative half cycle? The old total voltage will be wasted here. So that's why peak inverse voltage is 2 Vm here. Next, coming to the transformer utilization factor. Okay, transformer utilization will be denoted by the TUF. Transformer utilization factor will be defined as the ratio of DC power delivered to the load and AC rating of the transformer secondary. DC power delivered to the load and the ratio of the secondary transformer. Okay, this is the transformer utilization factor. So transformer utilization factor is the ratio of DC power delivered to the load and ratio of the secondary transformer. Next, coming to the form factor. Form factor is the ratio of RMS value to the DC value. It is the ratio of RMS value to the DC value. DC value. Form factor is the ratio of RMS value to the DC value. Off-wave rectifier of the form factor is 1.57. Okay, these are the characteristics of the off-wave rectifier. Efficiency, ripple factor, peak inverse voltage, transformer utilization factor and the form factor. These are the characteristics of the off-wave rectifier. Next, we will discuss about the full-wave rectifier. Okay, what is the disadvantage here? Okay, the disadvantage of off-wave rectifier is the only half cycle will be occurring, the remaining half cycle will be eliminated. That's why we will go to the full-wave rectifier. What is the advantage is we are using only single layer. Coming to the full wave rectifier, we are using 2 diodes. Okay, same as this, whatever we are using in the half wave rectifier, same as this we are using in the full wave rectifier. Additionally, we are using only extra diode. Okay, how much AC power supply we are using? 230 volts AC power supply, 50 hertz frequency. Okay, this AC input signal will be given to the transformer. Okay, this is the primary winding and the, this is the secondary winding. So we are using 2 diodes here, D1 and the D2. Negative half cycle.
okay, this is the input AC, this is the input signal of the input signal of this full wave rectifier. We are applying AC input voltage to the this. So what will happen in the first positive half cycle MI, what will happen in the next negative half cycle? Okay, what will happen in the first positive half cycle? Okay, when we are applying AC input voltage to the first positive half cycle, okay, for first positive half cycle when we are applying the AC voltage, so the diode D1 will be in the forward bias condition. How it will be in the forward bias condition means when we are applying supply voltage to this, the diode will be, how the current flow will be across A and the diode D1 and the lead resistor, the current will be diode D2 in the reverse bias condition. Okay, so the what will happen in the first positive half cycle, first positive half cycle, so the diode D1 will be in the forward bias condition, the first positive cycle will be produced. Okay, next what will happen in the reverse bias, in the next negative half cycle, the diode, next negative half cycle, diode D2 in the reverse bias, D2 in the forward bias condition, D1 in the reverse bias condition. So the next positive negative half cycle, only one cycle will be produced. So same as this, the process will be repeated here. Okay, so what is the advantage compared to the half wave rectifier? The two ways to both positive and off, negative half cycles will be produced. So there is no voltage. I think the difference is